Hi. If you receive 99% of positive compliments and 1% of negative feedback, which one would you think about the most? For a lot of us, it is that 1%. Have you ever wondered why? We are not born with it, but it grows along with us. Negative biases can dominate our lives. With this video, I intend to make you rethink negative biases and how you can take advantage of them. Let's begin. Consider this. During an appraisal discussion, you receive appreciation from your manager. But just as the discussion is about to end, he points out a potential problem with your behavior. This changes your mood instantly. You find yourself thinking about what he said for the rest of the day, looping those words over and over again in your head. This obviously impacts your mood, which impacts your behavior, and directly or indirectly, it impacts everyone around you. Did this ever happen to you? This is an example of a negative bias. And because they exist in our life, we tend to focus more on the bad rather than the good. Let me give you another example, this time of our news media. It's easy to blame people who put together news for highlighting the negatives. But in reality, that is exactly what we want. If one channel is sensationalizing bad news and the other only talking about good news, which one would you tune into? So yes, we, the audience, tend to focus much more on the bad news rather than the good. But should that be a bad thing? What if negative biases are good for us? Let me explain. Look back at your life and think about what contributed to your growth. What kind of a situation gave you your sense of purpose or meaning in your life? Listen to the stories of all achievers, the icons, leaders, the role models of the world. Their stories are not built on happy, cheerful times, so they rarely talk about it. Almost all talk about the struggling times, the stories of heartbreak, grit, and determination that they didn't know existed within them before the struggle. These give credit to their successes to the turbulent times that they went through. So you see, our negative biases give us motivation that fuels us forward when we are faced with adversities. And these adversities are often the results of change. Great. So how can you make negative biases work for you? By developing an entrepreneurial mindset. Typically, entrepreneurs believe that it's possible to improve life situation and live life in our own terms. They also believe in their own ability to learn, grow, adapt, and succeed. They see opportunity when others see problems and tragedy. In short, having an entrepreneurial mindset means you're taking advantage of all your negative biases. And I'll talk more about how you can do that in my next video. But the point of this video is to showcase to you that positive things do come out of negative biases. They help us keep alive, focus on threats. They help us become ambitious and improve the quality of our life. So my urge today is that understand the negative biases because it's absolutely natural for us. Accept it, embrace it, and work with it. I'd like to end today with this beautiful quote. Negativity is fuel. It's fire. You shouldn't lose it. What's a better motivator than revenge? When you're mad at someone, you do something about it. When someone tells you you can't do something, you prove them wrong. You shouldn't get rid of negativity. It's really important. That's it from me. Do you have any stories about converting negatives to positives? I'd love to hear from you. Do leave it in the comment section below, or you may reach out to me in any of the social media platforms. Thank you so very much for watching. If you like this video, please hit the like button and share it with your friends. And I'll see you next week. Until then, take good care of yourself. Bye.